Hello friends, in today's video we are going to discuss timing diagram of opcode fetch operation. So when we talk about a microprocessor based system, then in general there are two very important things. One is microprocessor itself and second thing is memory, because whatever we write and whatever program we write, it get stored in memory. So if you are writing some program, so that means you will store those that program into the memory. So this is our memory. And assume that at 2000 memory location in this memory, okay, I have written an instruction MBI A comma 06H. So in memory at address 2000, the opcode of MBI A will be stored. That means it is 3EH, and after that at memory location 2001, 06H will be stored. So the process of bringing opcode 3EH, the opcode of MBI A, process of bringing the opcode from memory into the microprocessor is called opcode fetch, and we are going to learn how to draw the timing diagram for this machine cycle. So let's see what will be the operation involved. First of all, microprocessor will have to enable the memory location. That means microprocessor will put value 2000 H on its address bus. Okay, these are the address bus. And after that, the data from memory. This time data means I'm talking about 3EH. And after that, you know, memory location 2000H will be enabled, and microprocessor can either read or write a value from that particular memory location. And as we are discussing about opcode fetch, so microprocessor may read the content present at 2000H. So for that, microprocessor will insert a RD bar signal, and the value of it will be low. That means at the RD bar pin of microprocessor, microprocessor will insert a low value. And due to that, the data present at memory location 2000, that means this time it is 3EH, it will be available to the microprocessor. So this is 3EH. Remember that in order to enable memory location 2000, microprocessor have kept the value of AD0 to AD7 and A8 to A15 at these all bits will be having 20H value, and all of these bits will be having 00 value. So you can see that lower order multiplexed address and data bus will have 00H here, but after read cycle microprocessor will get the opcode of 3H by the data bus. And you know, these lines AD0 to AD7, these behaves as address as well as data bus. That means earlier they will have 00H, and after read, after RD bar is equal to 0, they will have opcode of MBI, that is 3EH. And you must be knowing that these lines AD0 to AD7 behaves as address bus only for 1T state, only for 1T states, okay. And for rest of the T states, these lines behave as data bus. That means these lines are available to hold the data, and for only 1T state, these lines are available to hold the address. All right. And in order to tell this thing, microprocessor has a signal ALE, that stands for address latch enable. That means this signal, this pin of microprocessor is used to demultiplex the address and data bus. So when the content of ALE is 1, then AD0 to AD7 lines, that is AD0 to AD7 pins of microprocessor will have address on it. And when ALE will be 0, then these lines will be available to hold data. Alright. So we have discussed A2A15, that means it will have always 20H value, and AD0 to AD7 for first states it will have 00H, and after one T state it will be having 3E0H, because same lines will be used to hold the address as well as data. Alright, and after that RD bar signal will be required to get opcode from memory to microprocessor. And apart from these signals, microprocessor has IO/M bar pin. This is a pin of 805 microprocessor, and this is a status pin. That means it tells to the outer world that if the value of this pin is 1, that means microprocessor is performing an operation related to input and output devices. Okay, that means it will be running instruction related to input and output. And if this value, and if its value is 0, that means microprocessor is involved in some memory related operations. Okay, so remember these two things, that when it is 1, then input output operation will occur, and if it is 0, then memory related operation will run. And in opcode fetch, basically microprocessor is bringing opcode of particular instruction from memory to into the microprocessor. So it is a memory related operation. So here we will be using I/M bar as 0, because this is a memory related operation. Apart from that, there are also pins like S0 and S1, and for opcode fetch particularly, these pins have different values for different machine cycles. For opcode fetch, the values of these pins are 1 and 1. That means S0 will be having 1 and S1 will be having 1 for opcode fetch. So till now we have discussed all the pins that are required to draw a timing diagram for opcode fetch. Then let's see how will we draw this. Okay, so all right. So remember that for opcode fetch, in general 4 T states is required. That's why we are going to draw 4 equally spaced lines. No, 5 equally spaced lines. And duration between these lines are representing a T states. So this is our T states. Generally it starts from low going pulse, okay, that means from negative edge. So these are the clock pulses, and remember that its value will be the frequency of these clock pulses will be half of the frequency applied at the crystal oscillator. So these are the T states. And total T states that is used here is 4 T states. All right so from our example that we have discussed here, remember that first of all microprocessor put the value 2000H on the address bus in order to enable that particular memory location. So first of all we will be discussing AD0 to AD7 and A8 to A15, and remember that the content of A8 A15 was fixed for throughout the T states. Okay, so this is our T1 T states, this is T2, this is T3, and this is T4. So first of all we are drawing A8 to A15, and remember that when you are drawing value of a single pin, in that case you can represent a value by either like this, this is 1, this corresponds to 1, or you can draw like this corresponds to 0. But when there are a group of bits, that means you want to represent group of bits, that means you want to represent 8, 9H value. So what will you do? Because here some bits are 1 and some bits are 0. So in order to represent that, simply we use group of buses and we represent it like this, and we simply put the value here. It means that sum of bits are 1 and sum of are 0, and corresponding bits are 8, 9, that means 1000 and 10001. So let's see here. In our example, the upper address was 20H. So A8 to A15 will contain value 20H. That is, microprocessor will have to put a 20H at the upper 8 bits of address and data bus. So for 3T states, these will be holding a address 20H, and for last T states, these are generally unspecified. This is unspecified state. Okay, so here the value will be it will be a 20H for throughout the time. It will be having 20H because our upper 8 bits will be having 20H here. Then for lower 8 bits, I told you that for first T state only, it will have value 00H, because for first T states, these 80 to 87 lines are behaving as address bus. That's why for only first T states, these address line will be having value 00H. Remember that complete address is 2000H, where our first instruction, opcode of our instruction, is stored. So that's why 2 is here and 00H at the lower half of address bus. And because for only 1T states, these multiplex address line behave as address bus, that's why only for 1T states, these will be 00H will be available at address bus. Okay. And here I am showing that now these lines are after first T state, these lines are available for data bus. But you know, here we will not get any data until microprocessor will insert RD bar value 0. Okay, so we are waiting for RD bar. But before that, we have discussed ALE signal, that when these lines behave as address bus, in that case the content of ALE must be 1. ALE we use in order to demultiplex the address and data bus. Okay, so in order to show ALE 1, we will draw it like this. So for 1T state, its value is 1, and for rest of the T states, it will be 0. Remember, for every machine cycles, either it is opcode fetch, memory read, input output read, memory write, input output write, for all the machine cycles, for first T state, ALE will be 1, because for all the instructions, first of all, opcode fetch operation will be for all the instructions or for all the T states, first of all, these value will be having address, and after that, after one T state, this value will be having data. All right. So we have kept the value of ALE 1, and after that, we are going to draw RD bar signal. So in order to tell that whether this is a high or zero signal, we started from from high and then we put it low. But here this signal will be high for all the time, so it will be start for high, and when it is these lines 80 to 87 are available for data, then it will be inserted low by microprocessor. So when it is low, then only the opcode will appear here, and for our case opcode is 3EH, that is stored at 2000 location. So simply now here 3EH will be available. Earlier these lines were available for address, and then in second T state these lines were available for data, and when microprocessor inserted RD bar is equal to 0 at here in second T state, then we get a data 3EH there. Alright, and here 3EH data that I am saying, it is the opcode of instruction MVIA. Then after I discussed IO oblique mbar signal, so in order to show that, again we will write it here, IO oblique mbar, and as it is a memory related operation, so for throughout the cycle it will be low, because opcode fetch is a memory related operation. Microprocessor is fetching opcode from memory, so its value will be zero. And apart from that, there are S0 and S1 as I here discussed, and their value for opcode fetch is 1 1. So in order to reflect that, you can either draw further lines S1 and S0, or you can represent it also here. So I am writing it like S0 is equal to 1 and S1 is equal to 1, and that is for the case opcode fetch. Okay, so I think this is all about timing diagram of opcode fetch. And you know, in order to draw timing diagram of memory read, simply you will have to remove this fourth T state. Okay, because memory read cycle take only three T states, and all the fundamentals will be same that I have discussed here. So thank you for watching, and if you like my videos, then subscribe to my channel. Thank you.